Let's get right back to our interview about the 4th Street Festival in Bloomington, Indiana, with committee member artists Rebecca Lowery, Don Adams, and Kris Busch.
Rebecca, tell us about your arts journey, please.
Well, Kris has never been factory, so she's, that's just how she felt, I think. I was born and raised in Georgia, Northwest Georgia, Dalton area. I had a really crummy high school teacher, art teacher. She basically gave us some paper and the art supplies and let us just kind of be like free range.
Free range artists, yeah.
Yeah, free range artists. And I had, there was a potter's wheel and we had access to clay and she would firework if we made it. And I taught myself to fire and I threw one pot. Well, Northwest Georgia is in the very southern tip of the Appalachians.
Yep.
And I ended up getting into Berea College, which is a college in Kentucky, Berea, Kentucky, and it's a non-tuition school. And every student who goes there works for the school, and you have to be an Appalachian student or grew up in Appalachia. And so my job, my first labor assignment that lasted for 4 years was to work in the pottery, learning
how
to pottery, and to sell for the school. And so my first week of college, I was doing something, you know, I never would have thought of. And when people told you, what are you going to do when you grow up, you know, back in high school, I say, oh, I'm going to be an artist. And I quickly realized, no, I'm not going to make any money. I'm going to be a psychologist. And that threw out the window after being in the pottery for a while. And I kind of knew right away I wanted to be a potter because I loved it so much right away.
Yeah. Sounds like you immediately, going to that college, you immediately had the experience of not only being an artist, but being an artist business person.
Right.
Which is not, I mean, that's rare. So good for you.
It has a very unique model for mm-hmm. school, in that all of the students work for the school to pay their tuition. But we also Berea still continues this to today, a really excellent apprenticeship program. We were called apprentices the whole time, and you learn how to do clay from start to finish, from making the clay in a clay mixer.
Wow.
To firing it into the gas kilns. There was even, when new kilns need to be built, you would learn how to build kilns.
Wow.
A lot of people, I tell people, like, a lot of what we get at Berea, I don't know if it's still that way, but when I was there, what I got from Berea's undergrad program, graduate people don't get.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
So I went there through a lot of life's ups and downs. I ended up in Baltimore, Maryland at Baltimore Clayworks, which is a nonprofit ceramic arts organization. I spent 5 years in the office there, and I taught for 5 years classes there. And my husband got a job at IU when his job ended there, and we moved down here. And that's how I ended up being in Bloomington, moved with the husband. And, you know, because my studio, I could just move, you know.
Sure.
I had a whole lot of life issues that kept me from really going full 100% into doing ceramics as my main job. My husband's research grant disappeared.
Oh.
Funny how that works, you know.
Yeah.
And I'm like, well, why don't I just do this full time? Because I was making a little bit of money here and there doing it, and I was really involved with local clay. And I went full time doing art fairs.
Yeah, that's a lot of work. Yeah.
And, you know,
that is a full-time job. That's, yeah. Pack them up, unload them, sell them, load them. Yeah, that's a lot of work. Yeah.
5 years of administration work at Baltimore Clayworks really fit into a few of the arts organizations here in Bloomington now. Mm-hmm. I'm a part of Local Clay Potters Guild, 4th Street Art Festival. And I just recently joined By Hand Gallery in the co-op there. So just got my fingers in a lot of pies.
When do you sleep? No.
Nope. much lately. I do national juried exhibitions on top of art fairs. I'm actually doing a solo exhibition in Alexandria, Louisiana at the end of August with a workshop presentation, a two-day workshop there. And then the next week is Fourth Street.
Oh my gosh.
It's a little bit crazy. And I'm constantly making work, trying to keep up with orders.
Yeah. Yeah. Life of an artist, the life of a working artist.
I also do sculpture, but I don't, I was going to say, I have,
you'll send me pictures. I mean, you send a diverse things and I'll be able to put those. And when I put the podcast on the website, I'll try to create a image that has the 4th Street logo, and then for the part of the podcast that's, because I'll probably edit it into, several episodes, and there'll be images of whatever part of the podcast we're talking about. The images will be of that artwork, of you guys' artwork. So people will get a hint of that, and then in the videos that'll go on YouTube, I'll try to put as many pieces in as possible. So, do send images, all of you. Well, that's just so fascinating to me that your ceramics, both of you, Kris and Rebecca, your ceramics lives just kind of took off, and you were able to keep doing that the whole time. That's just amazing.
Stay tuned for the rest of our interview about the 4th Street Festival in Bloomington, Indiana, with featured artists Don Adams, Rebecca Lowery, and Kris Busch.